Hello fashion sewers, I hope you are well. If you're new to my channel, I'm Colleen Geely. Let's get into the video. So, I am not doing a tutorial. Yay. Now, you know I love doing tutorials, but I just wanted to share with you my favourites for 2021. And there have been several. It's been hard to make a choice of which ones I was going to choose for this video. But I think I made the right choices. I really do. But saying that, if you have your favourites, then please put those in the comment box below. So I'd love to know what you actually did refashion. First start, let me know that in the comments and which ones you enjoyed but you didn't necessarily have time to, or you're going to in 2022 decide to refashion any particular garment. Just let me know which ones are your favourite, you know, say top five, or maybe top five is not too much, maybe top three or top five. I'll leave that up to you. So let's get into the first one, which is this. Ta-da! Clutch bag, which was made from a skirt. And I have, I'm going to put pictures here of me wearing these items. And I have actually been out in this. The camera is blowing this out a little bit. And I love it. I didn't think I would be grabbing for it as much as I will do in the future. I mean, I've only been out once in this, but the fact that I had more or less everything that I carry in my small handbags that have a strap or some kind of handle, I think the plastic, which was a table mat, wasn't it, that I put in there, helped me to keep a handle on this, you know, so I could hold it in position. So yeah, I had fun with this. Yes, it was nice. Yeah, it's definitely a project that I would do again. If I found the right skirts, yeah, I'll definitely do another clutch. And it's quite big as well, because I actually did think, oh, maybe a bit too big to actually carry around or lug around, or, but no, it was fine. It was absolutely fine. So yeah, my favorite, one of my top five favorite ones. The next one, I'm not sure if you agree with this one, it's going to be this t-shirt. Oh, I just love how I constructed this. I think that's one of the main reasons. I haven't had an opportunity to wear this at the moment, but I have kind of made sure that if I needed to do any adjustments, then I could always tell you about any necessary adjustments that I do in my outfits of the week. So there isn't, and I do love it, and it will definitely get worn in 2022, for sure. I love this. I love the construction idea that I came up with for this. Let me just turn it onto the wrong side so you can see. I use curtain tape. That's what I use to create all this gathering and ruching effect. And I just love it. I really do. I know I'm going to say this, but I am going to say it. Yeah, I'll definitely make another one in 2022. Yeah, it's turned out well. It really has turned out well. See what refashioning can do? This is an oversized t-shirt, which is about three sizes too large, too big for me. And yeah, and I love what I managed to do with it. It's gorgeous. So that is, I'm going backwards on now, so that was five, this is four. They're in no particular order really, but I do like that. Yeah, really nice. Asymmetrical look that I like for my garments. For those of you that are new, I love asymmetrical looks to my garments. So yeah, you may find a lot of that on my channel. And also recently, a lot of, it's coming up. Anybody remember this one? Let me know in the comments. I didn't make this. It is actually a jacket that is back to front. So I actually wear this and I have worn this back to front, and I had so many compliments when I actually wore this. And people were saying to me, when I told them it's back to front, they were like, really? Seriously? Back to front, you know, with a look of confusion on their faces. And so since I showed them the back, oh right, it's like, oh, that's interesting. And says, yes, doesn't it feel uncomfortable? You know what, it really doesn't. It really, really does not. When you first put it on, you know that it's back to front. That's the thing, you know. And we all say, there's saying in fashion, isn't there, that you'll wear something that's really uncomfortable, really tight, because it's fashion. You've got to wear it. This isn't that situation. This feels uncomfortable the moment that you put it on. And then once you relax into it, it's probably the best thing for me to say. You don't realize it. You really do not realize it. I think the key is to make sure it is a couple of sizes bigger than your shape and belt it in. And it's a very simple project because all it took was one button. You need to watch the videos. I'll put links to all these videos in the description below so that you can watch them and get inspired and hopefully come up with something for yourself. But yeah, back to front jacket. And I'm gonna make another one. Have I said that about the other two? I have, haven't I? But I will. Because I'm a type of person that if I am going to explain to anybody about a certain technique, I need to know how it functions, how it works before I can comfortably give advice. So I definitely can do it with this back to front garments that I'm doing. Yeah, back to front garments. That's probably what I'll be known for, isn't it? So that was number four is going to be this dress. Right, I call this a slip-on sleeves. Let me just show you the sleeve. There's a sleeve, that's the original sleeve. So I call this a slip-on sleeve dress, and this is attached to this dress. And oh, I think, I'm trying to think whether I was quite pleased with the outcome of this. I was quite pleased with all of my projects, to tell you the truth. Not that I'm boasting or anything. But I actually used all of this original top. I'm not sure if it's a top or a dress. But it's quite long, so it could be either. It could have been a short mini dress, or it could have been a kind of longish kind of top. So I managed to get out of this dress. There was a flounce across the top of it that I put onto a t-shirt, which is also gorgeous. I was struggling whether to go with this one or the t-shirt, but I chose this one because of the sleeves. At the time of actually doing the video tutorial, I didn't have this floret detail here. That happened by accident, really, because that was the only scrap that was left over. And what I tend to do, or try to do, is to make sure I use everything that I possibly can within my refashion. And this was a scrap, and while it was just sitting on my work table, it's like, oh, right, that looks interesting. And yeah, I just kind of rolled it up into this kind of gorgeousness, and that's what you have. Yes, and it has this flounce here as well. So that is number four. Let me see. I want to make another one like this. I'll definitely go with the idea with the slip on sleeves, because I do like that. And yeah, I do like, yes, the sleeves, yes, I would. Absolutely. And finally, number five. Is this one. I can't really tell what it looks like, but the image here should help. But this one was the most challenging. I think I used that phrase in my video as well. Because I give myself a time scale in which to do each project, this went over time scale, even though a couple of them, it has taken me a couple of days in which to put it together, because obviously I do my filming, my editing and all that sort of thing, so it slows down the process of garment construction. But no, wow. And I also do test myself, so I got my garments on a rail and I just pull them out, and then that's when I decide to design and the creative process starts, and then I do a video. But I can also do it the way where I would actually sit down and get a sketchbook and a pencil and then design that way. But I'm enjoying the process of doing it this way, which I haven't really talked about. But this, oh yes, it's gorgeous. It's a bit a combination of back to front, because this section here where you see this frill, it's the front that was the frill here was down the center, and so it's got the front section going, well, it's horizontal, and then it has the front section at the back with the flounce here and the button, oh, it's gorgeous. And then it has rouleau loops there. Yes, it's so what I had in mind didn't actually work out, because I wanted it to be a little bit asymmetrical, and I need to stop thinking everything has to be asymmetrical. I do. But no, it turned out well. It really has turned out well. So all I need to do, and at the time there was a lot of hand sewing that needs to be involved in this in order to hide the seams, which I've done here. This, which is the overlock seam to keep it on the inside of the garment, so and you can't see any trace of it on the right side, and that takes time to do, which I didn't do at the time of the video, but it was still wearable, if that makes sense. But I just like to have that finished clean look to my garments. So yes, so that's it. So those are my favorites. Yeah, definitely my favorites for 2021. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up and please do share, and also hit that like button. And I will see you in 2022 with more refashioning ideas. So if you have any ideas that you want me to think about, or you want me to actually do on my channel, then please put those in the comment box below, and I will see what I can do for you. Until then, thank you for watching.